Hey guys, before I start this video, I want to thank you guys for watching my last couple of videos. We've been doing really well, and I thank you guys, and I want you guys to come back and keep on telling me what you think of my opinions, because a lot of you don't agree with them, and that's alright, you know, because we're starting a discussion here, and we're not here to fight in the chat. We're actually not fighting in the comments, I just made that up, but thank you guys for watching my last couple of videos. So let's get into this, guys. Boston versus Toronto, 2-2 series in Boston. It's a great game. No one scores for two periods, and then with 8 minutes left in the third, Toronto takes a goal, and it's controversial. Why isn't it never controversial? Like, if there was nothing controversial in the NHL, I wouldn't even have three videos up on this channel. So let's get into it. Obviously, it's a crucial goal. No one scored. It's low shooting. You know, nobody's breaking anything. Great defense from both teams, and Austin Matthews, 1x1 on his offside, obviously. Snipe. Boom. But goalie interference? Coach's challenge comes in. Let's take a look.
Here's Matthews, gets control. Muzzin walks in to Matthews. He shoots, he scores!
Boston has challenged a play to net for goaltender interference.
Let's have a closer look at Zach Hyman against Tukka Rask.
Oh boy, I think just watch the reaction after Hyman cross-checks McAvoy. He actually loses his balance. He gets up, cross-checks, then he kind of stumbles, and he does knock into Rask. Rask's response is immediate. You know, so often this year, Jim, they've been trying to let more of these go, but there's the contact. Now comes the shot. This is going to be a tough one not to overturn.
After reviewing the play, the call on the ice stands. We have a good goal.
Wow.
So the call on the ice was a goal.
So as you can see, I mean, it's debatable. It's up for grabs. What do you think? Before I say anything, comment down below. What do you think? Was it goalie interference? I'm going to just sit here and wait for you to comment so I can get this video to 10 minutes. No, I'm just kidding. This video will not be close to 10 minutes. But what do you guys think? Well, was it actually goalie interference? And here's my opinion. It's obvious that there is interference by the Toronto player. For sure. There's no doubt about that. There's no doubt in my mind that there is interference with the Toronto player and Tukka Rask. But it's about where Rask is placed. He's outside the crease, but he's also inside the crease. And for the first time on this channel, I can't make a decision. Honestly, I can't decide whether it was inside. It's actually biased if I say, because I really do want Boston to win this series because I don't like Toronto. But I have to be as neutral as I can, so I can't actually make a decision, and I want to say it's goalie interference, but I actually can't say it is either, because it's just kind of in the middle, and I guess by me saying I want Boston to win, I would say it is goalie interference, but honestly, it's up for grabs. It's really, it was just down to the wire, and you can say that, yeah, the call went to Toronto, and Toronto reviewed it, and they gave him a goal, and Toronto took the lead. It's biased. Sure. But on the other hand, I mean, you can't say that the Toronto room that's in the NHL review system in Toronto is biased. They work for the NHL. They don't work for Toronto. So that's out of the question. But it was interesting. I just realized I left Overwatch in the background. The Overwatch League is going on. Actually, I think, oh no, it's still Houston and Philly. Anyways, just ignore that. We're talking about hockey. Seriously, it was too close to call. Anyways, they come back anyways into the period, and they're up by one. They get their goal, and they go in, and
we got some support from Hainsey. He had support from Matthews, and two quick passes. Morgan Riley's out to center. Andreas Johnsson moves in front. Kapanen scores! Kasperi Kapanen's first playoff goal.
They score again. So they score, and it's a—I mean, it's just garbage goaltending. It's the same thing. Rask did the exact same thing as he did in the first. He was so far off, back to the same side, and he made the same mistake again, and it's a goal. I can't believe that. I mean, how do you make the same mistake twice? Anyways, he gets scored on, and it's 2-0. Either way, Toronto takes a 3-2 series lead. Going back into Toronto, that's huge for them. They can possibly end it. It could be over. Boston can finally be eliminated by Toronto. What do you think is going to happen? Do you think that Toronto will be taken home to the second round. That made sense, right? They'll be going to the second round. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. And was it interference? Was it goalie interference? Was it not goalie interference? Let me know what you think. Anyways, thanks for watching the video. Make sure you subscribe, and I hope to have you guys back for another conversation whenever something controversial has. Maybe there was a hit from behind. Someone please do something controversial so I can upload a video and I don't have to be some boring analytical, you know, let's look at Tampa Bay's failure sort of channel. All right, let's get some controversy going. I'm just kidding. I really hope nobody gets injured in the playoffs. We want full teams. We want nobody injured. All right, I'll see you guys later.